Jerry Lawler, and our special guest tonight, the Hall of Famer, Jim Ross.
Wait a minute, special guest? Are you kidding? We're under the Triple H regime now, simply to know. JR, welcome back permanently.
Thanks, gang. I appreciate it. Almost going to see Cole. What an ovation for CM Punk. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we invite you all to follow the action on Twitter by following at WWE and joining the conversation using the hashtag Raw here tonight. What an incredible reaction for CM Punk here tonight in Indianapolis, Indiana, the home of the Pacers.
Well, you can bet the tweets are flying worldwide right now because a lot of people, including me, never expected to see CM Punk back WWE ring. Thousands and thousands of fans here on their feet for the WWE champion. One of them at least.
Some are booing, some are cheering, Punk.
Mixed reaction, but a reaction nonetheless.
And now the $64,000 question. Why, oh why, after everything I said and after everything I did, why did I come back? I'm a bit of a storyteller. If I could be afforded a little bit of your time, I want to tell you a little bit of a story. I've known for a very long time that my contract with WWE expired on July 17th, 2011. So as far as a year back, I was struggling with this monumentous, life-changing decision that I had to make. On one hand, and believe me, ladies and gentlemen, I love the place I work. I just hate the people in charge. And therein lies my decision. I could have either re-signed and dealt with the soul-crushing status quo, or I had a choice to speak my mind and maybe cause a little bit of change in my wake. And obviously, and you know my decision, I spoke my mind, and lo and behold, I caused just a little bit of change, didn't I? The domino effect, as it's known. I mean, the next night on Monday Night Raw, Vincent K. McMahon was relieved of his day-to-day duties. And there it is. That's change. That's tangible change. I can feel it in the air. I know all of you can feel it in the air, too. And I'd like to take a little bit of credit for that change. But I think a lot of the credit also lies on the shoulders of you, the audience. See, for far too long, you've been fed scraps. For far too long, you haven't been given what I feel you're entitled to. I'm here to give that to you. I'm here to make this fun again. I'm going to make this fun again for everybody. Am I a little bit unorthodox? Am I unpredictable? Do people get scared when CM Punk shows up with a microphone? You damn betcha, man, and I'd have it no other way. As proud as I was about backing up everything I said, I was sitting at home and I was looking at the WWE Championship, and I realized that the voice of the voiceless needs to be heard. My voice needs to be heard by the people who need to hear it the most, and that's you.
I think he's a little arrogant.
I can't do that with a megaphone in various media outlets. I can't do it at Comic-Con. I can't do that at Jimmy Kimmel. What it boils down to is I can't change this place for the better. I can't make this business and this industry what it can and should be sitting on my couch in Chicago. So I picked up the phone. As much as I hate being on the telephone, I made the phone call to come back, believe it or not. And by the looks of it, my timing couldn't have been better. In my short absence, we've already reverted back to the soul-crushing status quo. John Cena is parading around as the WWE Champion.
Another mixed reaction.
And see, John Cena is as much WWE Champion as this guy sitting front row right here with his Shop Zone replica championship title belt. See, what you have is a belt. What I have is a championship title. So much for change, huh? Same old, same old. John Cena, no matter what the outcome of whatever bogus championship tournament that we had while I was on vacation, no matter who in that locker room thinks they're entitled to rematches, one fact, I hold in my hands the most important title in the world. This right here indicates to everybody, beyond a shadow of a doubt, I am the best professional wrestler this world has to offer. I am the one, the only WWE Champion. Feel that, digest that. I am the WWE Champion. Time to play heroin, it's time to play the game.
Well said. Ladies and gentlemen, there's the Chief Operating Officer of WWE, Triple H, and earlier today on Twitter, John Cena called this, quote, the most important RAW of Triple H's life. So many decisions for this man to make. He promised us on SmackDown Friday night that he was going to clear up the WWE Championship situation here on RAW.
Well, this capacity crowd, amazing response. They're on their feet for the game. So far, I think everyone likes Triple H being in charge.